So this was joint work with my equal co-author Emanuel Laude, Michael Möller, Jan Dellmann and Daniel Kremers. So many variational approaches in computer vision, such as image denoising, stereo matching, or optical flow, can be solved by minimizing energies of the following form, where we minimize the sum of a pointwise data term plus a regularizer, which is here the total variation. And for the example of stereo matching, one would seek the minimizer of functions u, which map from the image domain omega to the set of disparities gamma. And the stator term rho would here, for example, encode the matching cost between the two images given the pixel x in the image and the disparity u of x. So why is this interesting and why are these problems challenging? So as we've seen, many problems in computer vision follow this form. And the challenge is the non-convexity of this problem. So due to the non-convex data term, this is a non-convex optimization problem, and these are quite tough to solve. So one option is, of course, to use classical methods such as gradient descent or linearization methods in a coarse-to-fine scheme to optimize these energies. But the problem there is that one only gets local optima, is dependent on the initialization, and also one often has many unintuitive parameters. As we will shortly see, there are also methods to globally optimize such energies. And the problem with these globally global optimization methods is the continuity of this range gamma. And this will be the content of this talk, how to extend these global optimization methods to handle this continuous range that we often face in these problems in a natural and efficient way. So in the computer vision community, a breakthrough in solving these optimization problems, these non-convex optimization problems in a globally optimal way, was proposed by Ishikawa in 2003. So the idea there is to, instead of optimizing just over the function from omega to gamma, is to consider the product space, omega times gamma. And in this product space, we formulate a graph, and he showed that by obtaining a graph cut in this product space, one can find the globally optimal solution to this non-convex optimization problem. But due to the discretization of the domain omega and due to the discretization of the range gamma by this graph structure, one gets significant grid bias and label bias. Subsequently, this construction from Ishikawa was generalized to the continuous setting by Pocket et al. In 2008. And there the idea is similar, that one optimizes over the product space omega times gamma, but instead of having this discrete graph construction, one optimizes over a continuous function, which encodes the graph of the original function. So it's a function which maps from omega times gamma to 0, 1. And there one can prove similar optimality guarantees, but due to the continuous formulation, one can also perform isotropic regularization, which eliminates the grid bias. But eventually, one still has to discretize the range gamma. So even with this continuous formulation, one still has a label bias. And this is the point of this work here, to now look at this discretization of gamma, if we can do better here. So let me illustrate on the example of stereo matching what this discretization of gamma, what problems it gives. So here we have a stereo pair, and if one now solves this with this multi-label approach, this continuous multi-label approach, and discretizes gamma in two labels, we don't recognize the motor cycle, but we get a two-region segmentation. And of course, we can finer and finer discretize this range gamma, but then quickly, due to this product space, the formulation becomes intractable. So for 128 discretization labels, we have a memory requirement of 4.3 gigabytes. And with the method here, we propose that we can solve this problem using only 8 labels and still get a very smooth disparity map at a fraction of the required runtime and memory. So the main idea, as I will explain in this talk, is that here for this non-convex stereo matching energy, we show that the traditional labeling methods, they perform a piecewise linear approximation of this non-convex energy, while the proposed approach performs a piecewise convex approximation, which is much more faithful to the original non-convex energy. So there's some related work from the discrete optimization community. So Markov random fields with continuous state spaces, continuous graphical models. This was proposed by Zach and Cooley in 2012 and also analyzed by Fix and Agarwal in 2014. But these are formulated in a spatially discrete setting. And here we consider the spatially continuous setting. So a sublabel accurate spatially continuous multilabeling method was already proposed by Lehmann et al. In 2013, but they solely focused on the total variation regularizer. And actually, they focused on vectorial labels and labels on manifolds. And here, for the setting that we consider here, this method reduces to this method from Pock et al. From 2008. So it has the same label bias. So the key contributions of this work is the first spatially continuous, fully sublabel accurate formulation. We provably show that we obtain the tightest local convex relaxation. And our method also unifies lifting and direct convex optimization approaches. So, okay, what is the idea of convexification and functional lifting? So, suppose here we have a non-convex function given at a pixel x in the image. And the idea is to, what one can do to obtain a convex problem is to just take the Legendre-Fentel biconjugate, the convex envelope, then one has a convex problem, but one loses lots of information, so this concave part in the center is lost. So the idea is instead to take a different perspective on this energy and transform it into a higher dimensional space. And by doing so, we essentially fold the non-convex energy along the edges of the hypercube. And so we go from this one-dimensional representation to a higher dimensional representation. And what we show in the paper is that the traditional multilabeling methods, what they essentially do is they sample this lifted energy at the points, at the labels, and then compute the convex envelope. And this leads to a linear relaxation, which is easy to optimize with graph cuts or linear programming methods. What we propose to do is to assign the cost not only at these black points, but also at the solutions in between, at the red lines, and then we compute the convex envelope after that. So this leads to a much closer approximation of the original energy. And it turns out this is not linear anymore, but it's still convex, so we can still optimize it. Okay, so how is this done in a more mathematical precise way? So we have folded this energy along the basis vectors of this higher dimensional space. Of course, this can be done for n labels in the n-dimensional space, but for the sake of illustration, I will stick to the two-dimensional example here, or the three-dimensional example. So we fold this non-convex energy along this edges here, and these basis vectors can also be identified with the labels of this one-dimensional energy. And then we can reformulate here the energy in the higher dimensional space along this folded edge, just as the original energy if we are on the edge. So if we are moving along the convex combinations between these basis vectors, we assign the green, the original energy function. And if we are outside of this set, we assign the value infinity. So this red row of U is still a non-convex function, but what we show in our paper is that this tightest convex extension, which is shown in blue here, this blue surface, we can find an analytical closed form solution for this tightest convex envelope, and it turns out it's a support function of a convex set C, and this convex set C is actually characterized by the epigraphs of the convex conjugates of the individual pieces of this non-convex energy. And the main step during implementation is the orthogonal projection onto these epigraphs of these pieces. And so far, we've implemented piecewise linear and quadratic pieces. So this was the main construction for the data term. For the regularizer, it turns out the total variation can also be lifted to this higher dimensional space. And we show in our paper that for the sublabel accurate formulation, we still can use the same regularizer as from this paper of Pock et al. From 2008. So this is a proof in the paper. And combining the data term and the regularizer, we end up with a convex concave saddle point problem, which can be solved efficiently on a GPU using a first order Prime-and-Dual algorithm. Okay, so now we have obtained the solution to this higher dimensional lifted problem. How do we go back to the original problem? It's simple, we just back project it to the lower dimensional space and obtain our solution. Okay, so we evaluated our method on first on a convex model. This is nice because we can compute the global optimal solution just by using direct optimization method. And what we show is that our sublabel accurate approach finds the same solution as the direct optimization with almost no overhead. So this provides a natural transition between direct optimization and functional lifting. And even if we use 10 labels, we still find the exact the same solution as the direct optimization approach. The traditional multi-labeling methods, even if you use 8 labels, they converge to our suboptimal results while requiring much more memory. And if we increase the number of labels, the result gets better, but it's still suboptimal. Actually, even for 256 labels, which amounts to an optimization problem of size 3.6 gigabytes, the result is still optimal, while our proposed method with 2 labels already yields the correct solution. Okay, so for stereo matching, the scenario is similar. Traditional methods, even with 48 labels, result in a quite discrete depth map where one can see the label bias. And our sublabel accurate solution produces a smooth depth map using only 8 labels at a fraction of the runtime and the memory requirement. And directly comparing the two methods for equal amounts of labels, we see that even with 2 labels, our method already produces a reasonable result. And if we increase the number of labels, we soon get very good results for the stereo matching, while the standard multi-labeling methods, essentially it's an 8-region segmentation of the depth map, while we already get a quite smooth result. So to conclude my talk, we proposed the first spatially continuous sublabel accurate relaxation for a certain class of non-convex energies, which can be written as the sum of a non-convex data term plus the total variation, and we require far fewer labels than the traditional lifting techniques. And this leads to substantial improvements in runtime and memory. So, and it generalizes the traditional lifting methods from piecewise linear to piecewise convex approximations, as shown in the figure here. Thank you very much. Code is online.